one of Delhi's historical jewels, Humayun's tomb is a significant monument for more than one reason. This grand mausoleum is the first tomb of a Mughal emperor to be built in India. But over the years, it also came to be the resting place of more than 150 Mughal family members. A fine example of Persian architecture, which created a template for Mughal architecture. This beautiful mausoleum is also the resting place of Emperor Shah Jahan's son, Dara Shikoh, Humayun's two wives, and later Mughal emperors as well. From being a stunning 16th century memorial to becoming a refugee camp during the partition of India in 1947, Humayun's tomb has many tales to tell. Interestingly, the tomb we see today on Mathura Road in Nizamuddin, Delhi, wasn't the first resting place of Humayun. On his death in January 1556, his body was first buried in his palace in Purana Kila in Delhi. But it had to be removed to a temporary tomb in Sirhind in Punjab after Hemu, a general under Adil Shah Suri of the Suri dynasty, advanced upon Delhi in 1556. It is said that the emperor's body was reburied in Deen Pinaha by his son and successor Akbar before finally being moved to the tomb, which was completed in 1571. The tomb itself was built in Humayun's memory on the orders of his wife, either Bega Begum or Haji Begum. While some records say that Haji Begum was Humayun's first wife, Bega Begum, others claim she was Akbar's mother and Humayun's second wife, Hamida Bano Begum. Most scholars identify Haji Begum as Bega Begum, who was so called because she was on a Hajj pilgrimage. However, there are varying narratives about the date of construction of the tomb as well as who constructed it. While some 19th century scholars say construction began in 1565, others, referring to an old manuscript by Sagin Beg, late 18th century, say the foundations were laid in Akbar's 14th year of reign, 1569. Humayun's tomb was the first grand tomb of the Mughals in India, and it influenced many of the Mughal monuments that followed, including the grand mausoleum of Shah Jahan, the Taj Mahal. The tomb is the first distinct example of Mughal architecture, which was inspired by Persian architecture. Naturally, the architect had to be carefully chosen, and Mirak Mirza Ghiyas was appointed. Ghiyas had plenty of experiences working on the great Persian monuments in Herat and Bukhara, as well as the Sultanate buildings in India. It is said that Haji Begum was so taken by Persian architecture while in exile with her husband at the court of the Safavids in Persia that she personally commissioned Mirak Mirza Ghiyas for the tomb. But Ghiyas died during its construction, and it was his son Sayyid Muhammad who completed the mausoleum. There are some scholars who believe that the main patron of this grand project was Akbar. Probably because during much of its construction, Haji Begum was away on a Hajj pilgrimage. But it is important to note that Mughal women were great builders and quite prosperous. And therefore, it is quite possible that Haji Begum had commissioned the mausoleum. It is also possible that her role was more than just supervisory. She also commissioned the architects of the tomb. Humayun's tomb was built not only in honor of the emperor. It is a symbol of the growing political and cultural might of the Mughal dynasty at that time. Thank you. Humayun's tomb has many striking features. It was probably the largest tomb in the entire Indian subcontinent at that time. The tomb stands on a raised plinth, which has as many as 56 cells or small chambers on all four sides. It is a garden tomb, and as an example of the classic Charbagh, which is a four-quadrant garden with four water channels of Quranic paradise represented. The tomb stands right in the middle of this garden, which is spread across 30 acres. The striking symmetry of the structure in an equally symmetrical garden is a visual treat. The other important features of the tomb is the marble dome, which is actually a double dome and is probably a first of its kind in the subcontinent. The double dome consists of two layers with a gap between them. The dome is flanked by chhatris or domed pavilions, and the domes of the central chhatris are adorned with glazed ceramic tiles. The main chamber under the dome houses Humayun's cenotaph. The main chamber also carries the symbolic element, a mihrab, designed over the central marble lattice or jali faced Mecca to the west. Humayun's tomb is a glorious example of Mughal architecture. Visit it and you will find a monument that has a special place in the history of the Mughals in India.